The next game is Not the Whole Story, which is a storytelling game for 2 to 4 players. It takes about 25 minutes to play, depending on how long you tell your story. You are the fates weaving together people's lives and stories. And what you're trying to do is work together with the other players to craft a story that follows the twists and turns of the dice. Each turn, you're going to tell a little bit of the story related to the die you place. Start by setting 2 dice to end caps. One of those is going to be the beginning of the story, and one of those will be the end, which you set aside for later. Then you evenly distribute all the rest of the dice. Let's say we're going to play with 2 players, so we'll have 8 on each side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There we go. First, you choose a genre for the story and a basic setting and a character or two to populate the story. We might have let's say this is a mystery story that takes place in Kansas, and the main characters are Sam and Dottie. And we could also agree on anything else we want. Could be a specific challenge they need to overcome. Choose which player is going to take the first turn, and then play passes clockwise. On your turn, you do the following. You can roll any number of your dice. Let's say I want to roll these 3 dice. And then you must place one of your dice next to the die that was most recently played, making a connection between them. The dice must connect, and you can't place something so that it closes off, so that it doesn't make a connection. Even if you were to play a couple like this, here, we then can't place something like that that's going to close things off. We'd have to keep it going, keep the story going. And if the most recently played die does not have any more open paths, but a previous die does, let's say we've done this, and then this has gotten closed off, and you can't play there anymore, then obviously you can go back and play one of the earlier connections. Don't close the last path of the story unless everyone agrees it's time to end the story. If you can't play any of your dice, then go ahead and pick them up and roll them all until you can play one of them. Then you must continue the story based on the die that was just placed. So, if you play an end cap, then you bring a part of the story to a logical close. Could be wrapping up a thread of the tale, concluding an important tension in the story, so on. If you place a chain, you continue the story in a logical way, extending the plot points or tensions. If you place a corner, then you continue the story, but you add a twist. Whenever possible, if you have a curved corner, you want a natural, smooth turn in the plot, while the sharper corners could be more surprising turns or even a shift in genre, something like that. Branch, which would be something like this. You then continue the story, but you introduce a branch in the story. It might be a dilemma where a character needs to make a choice, or an event with 2 possible results. And then a crossing, something that opens the story up wide as to what might be happening next. Make sure the story can go quite a few different ways from where you end your turn. After the final player has played their final die, you can place the end cap you set aside to bring the story to an apt conclusion. You can agree on something together as to what makes sense about the end of the story. But if some of the paths were not closed with that final die, let's say this one were right here, and we still had something a little bit open, then something about the story could remain open-ended. One of the problems might not have been completely solved, and we might be able to come back to it later in another game. And that is Not the Whole Story.